It was a dark and stormy night when she came to me. She was a voluptuous dame, about 6 feet tall, and with a look of terror in her eye. She needed to clean up some bloodstains, if you catch my drift. Then the commercials ended, and I went back to watching SpongeBob. But right when it was getting to the best part, my assistant Fatson came running in.
Detective Discovery!
Slow down, sport. It's almost as if...
someone's dead!
This is quite the conundrum. If I leave now, I won't be able to see Patrick do something stupid. You can control time? Well, why didn't you tell me? Do you know what we can do with these powers?
Sir, could you please just follow me?
As you wish, Father Time.
Body.
Are you sure you weren't lied to?
Sir, you're standing on. Sir? Fingerprints?
Right you are, my boy. That's why I'm going to use my fingerprint analyzer.
Isn't that your cell phone?
It is, but it isn't. This here is my fingerprint analyzer disguised as a cell phone. Us detectives need to have special gadgets for doing special tricks.
My word. This is truly a shocker.
What is it?
It seems I'm getting a call from Mother. I don't remember giving her my number. Why, hello, Mother!
Sorry, I thought I gave you my number a while ago. Yes, I packed my lunch right. Yes, I put on clean underwear, but do I have to say that out loud? You're embarrassing me. Okay, I gotta go. I love you too. Bye.
Are you quite finished?
Not quite. I received a message from a Nigerian prince. Apparently, if I invest $50,000... country.
Your deduction?
Actually, it's quite simple.
It was none other than the evil, diabolical, charming Dr. Sprinkles on his little Sunday walk.
When he spotted a lone trash can that was just asking to be knocked over.
Enraged, our victim came running out to tell him off. However, Sprinkles just simply does not enjoy fine trash receptacles, and he was not amused by the man's anger, so he pulled out his gun and ended it.
You know, Discovery, you are the dumbest man I know, but your deductions are... spot on.
That is why I'm the detective and you're just the lackey. Maybe someday you can grow up to be a magnificent detective like I am.
Let's just get out of here. I'm cold.
Come out of hiding, Dr. Sprinkles.
One does not go through 7 years of pursuing a doctorate in ice cream toppings without learning something about common courtesy. Even if you have just broken into my home during tea time, I cannot help but be courteous to all my guests. Follow me, Mr. Discovery. Little Fatson.
Oh my goodness.
So, I presume that you're here to pin yet another murder case on me?
Yes, and we're gonna put an end to it once and for all.
Oh, Mr. Discovery. You ever noticed you have the most humorous sense of humor?
Well...
why are you looking at me like that?
You know...
spit it out!
Our plan?
What plan? We never have a plan. Oh yeah!
Reach for the sky.
you're planning on shooting me with a water pistol that you probably have gotten at the dollar store on the drive here?
It's a real gun.
No, it is quite clearly a water pistol.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. It is quite clearly orange. What type of orange guns do you know of? I'll tell you. Water pistols.
How can you tell? This movie is in black and white.
Touché. But it's still clearly made of plastic anyway. Like, what type of... How can you kill me with a water pistol?
Well, I was gonna squirt chlorine into your tea right there.
Did all you two fine young gentlemen see my new puppy out the window?
But the blinds are shut.
Oh, silly me. Well, it wasn't that remarkable of a dog anyway. Oh, bother. It appears that there's no beverages around for any insipid detectives to shoot chlorine into.
Darn.
But you just had...
Now, young Fatson. Hasn't anyone ever told you that stuttering is very rude?
He's right. If you don't behave yourself, we're leaving right now.
But that's his plan.
Alright, we're leaving. No. See you later, Dr. Springer.
Wait, what are you
Goodbye.
Doing? You idiot! I just don't understand this.
That's okay. I don't understand anything. Hey, I guess I was a little harsh on you back there. I'll make it up to you. How about we go out for some ice cream?
A sizable sundae sounds good right now.
Okay, but not too big. I gotta get back to SpongeBob before time spell wears off.
For the last time, I can't control time.
You say that now, but when you're trying to impress girls, that one's a home run.